Hi everyone, today's book is Possum Magic by Mem Fox and Julie Vivas. Once upon a time, but not very long ago, deep in the Australian bush lived two possums. Their names were Hush and Grandma Poss. Grandma Poss made bush magic. She made wombats blue and kookaburras pink. She made dingoes smile and emus shrink. But the best magic of all was, make a prediction. Before we move on to the next page, write down in your book, what do you think the best bush magic that Grandma Poss can do is? But the best magic of all was the magic that made Hush invisible. Do you think that's exciting magic? I think that's pretty exciting. I'd like you to write down for me, what would you do if you were invisible? If no one could see you, what would you do? Let's find out what Hush did. What adventures Hush had. Because she couldn't be seen, she could be squashed by koalas. That sounds a bit dangerous. It doesn't sound like fun at all. Because she couldn't be seen, she could slide down kangaroos. That sounds fun. Do you think the kangaroos would like that? Write down if you think the kangaroos would like that or not, and write down why. Because she couldn't be seen, she was safe from snakes, which is why Grandma Poss made her invisible in the first place. That snake looks pretty dangerous to me. But one day, quite unexpectedly, Hush said, "Grandma, I want to know what I look like. Please could you make me visible again?" "Of course I can," said Grandma Poss, and she began to look through her magic books. Why do you think Hush didn't want to be invisible anymore? I'd like you to write that down. Why do you think Hush got tired of being invisible? She looked into this book, and she looked into that. There was magic for thin, and there was magic for fat. And magic for tall, and magic for small. But the magic she was looking for wasn't there at all. This sounds like a bit of a problem. What do you think will happen if Grandma Poss can't find the solution? Will Hush have to stay invisible forever? How do you think Hush might feel about that? I'd like you to write down how you think Hush would feel if she had to stay invisible forever. Grandma Poss looked miserable. "Don't worry, Grandma," said Hush. "I don't mind." But in her heart of hearts, she did. I don't think Hush is very happy at the moment. I think she might be a bit sad about having to stay invisible. All night long, Grandma Poss thought and thought. The next morning, just before breakfast, she shouted, "It's something to do with food! People food, not possum food, but I can't remember what. We'll just have to try and find it." So later that day, they left the bush where they'd always been to find out what it was that would make Hush seen. So we know that it's some kind of food that will make Hush visible again. I'd like you to make another prediction. Write down what kind of food you think it would take to make Hush visible again. They ate Anzac biscuits in Adelaide, Mornay and Minties in Melbourne, steak and salad in Sydney, and pumpkin scones in Brisbane. Hush remained invisible. "Don't lose heart," said Grandma Poss. "Let's see what we can find in Darwin." What states have Grandma Poss and Hush been to? They've been to Adelaide, Melbourne, Sydney, Brisbane, and they're about to go to Darwin. What states have they been to so far, and what states haven't they been to? It was there, in the far north of Australia, that they found a Vegemite sandwich. Grandma Poss crossed her claws and crossed her feet. Hush breathed deeply and began to eat. "A tail! A tail!" shouted both possums at once, for there it was, a brand new visible tail. How do you think Hush feels now? She's only partially visible. Do you think that might look a bit funny if walking down the street you saw a tail walking along? That would look a bit odd, wouldn't it? Later, on a beach in Perth, they ate a piece of pavlova. Hush's legs appeared, so did her body. "You look wonderful, you precious possum," said Grandma Poss. "Next stop, Tasmania." And over the sea they went. How are they getting to Tasmania? We can see Grandma Poss and Hush in an umbrella. Do you think they'd make it all the way to Tasmania in an umbrella? Write down if you think they would or not, and write down why. In Hobart, late one night in the kitchens of the casino, they saw a Leamington on a plate. Hush closed her eyes and nibbled. Grandma Poss held her breath and waited. "It's worked! It's worked!" she cried. And she was right. Hush could be seen from head to tail. Grandma Poss hugged Hush and they both danced "Here We Go Round the Leamington Plate" till early in the morning. And you can see them there dancing. How do you think Hush feels now? I'd like you to write that down for me. And how do you think Grandma Poss feels? She was a little bit worried earlier in the book because she couldn't find a solution to make Hush visible again. Now they found the solution. How do you think she's feeling? I'd like you to write that down for me as well. From that time onwards, Hush was visible. But once a year, on her birthday, she and Grandma Poss ate a Vegemite sandwich, a piece of pavlova, and half a Leamington, just to make sure that Hush stayed visible forever. And she did. And that's the end of the story. Now, this is an interesting book because someone gets to go invisible. Now, I've already asked you to write down what you would do if you were invisible, but I'd like you to write down what are the dangers of being invisible. One of the dangers that Hush faced was that because she couldn't be seen by the koalas, she could be squashed. What dangers would we face if we couldn't be seen? Do you think it would be safe to cross the road? What else might we have to think more carefully about?